Hello, hacky friends. You guys might know me from the internet as djneo. And today I'm here to talk about a little bit project I've been working on for almost 3 years now. And it's called 2KHS, aka 2K Hockey Simulator.
Now, what is 2KHS exactly? Well, 8 years ago, Visual Concepts, the award-winning studio behind the NBA 2K, was developing the next generation hockey running on the same engine as NBA 2K. This new NHL from 2K was developed on PCs, four modern PCs, the current generations of consoles at that time, and Wii. Unfortunately for us, the hockey fans, 2K, the publisher behind the NHL 2K, decided to release only the stripped-down, optimized Wii version of the game, which scaled down textures, low-poly models and arenas, and really poor LOD everywhere you look at. So even the Wii hardware could handle and render the advanced physics with the NBA 2K high standards gameplay mechanics that, luckily for us, survived this optimization just in very poor shape. Now, everybody that ever played the NHL from 2K, and I mean basically any NHL from 2K, even the very old ones, would probably agree that these games have a great potential with beautifully organic gameplay, tons and tons animations for basically anything that can ever happen on the ice in the real world. It was just all plugged with buggy animations and some direction decisions that doesn't make much sense with what is actually happening on the ice in the game. It often seemed to me that the tuning of the game was not on the same page with the animation, with the motion capture, or the overall major hockey heart of the game. The speed of animations, for example, was way off most of the time. Some animations runs ridiculously fast, most of them actually. Some even a little bit too slow or sluggish. At the end, the game looked very unpolished, honestly, more like a badly done but promising tech demo or prototype. It almost seemed to me that one person that worked on the game wanted a pure sim, and the other one that was responsible for the final tuning wanted pure arcade game, and it just couldn't work for anybody. But even with all these issues and ugly mess sometimes, you could feel that under the hood, the core of the game plays so fantastic game of hockey that many of us learn to overlook the flaws and enjoy the game with some help of the sliders, of course. Realistically though, we all know that sliders can't fix everything. Quite honestly, with such unfinished and some would say broken games as the NHL 2K9, 2K10 and 11 was, you could barely scratch the surface of what needed to be done. Neither you can fix that much by changing all around player attributes. I tried it all, dozens of combinations, dozen times. Alright, enough with the old games, let's talk about the future of 2K Hockey. We've come a long way, there is a lot to be excited about, so here we go. Now, before we start, I would really love to introduce to you one more try the guy that was so kind enough and smart enough to actually write the codes for all the tools I need to really fix the issues, significantly improve the gameplay and the visuals of the game. With these tools, I was able to basically break down the game into the pieces and then start again with one simple goal in my head. Make everything as physics-based and realistic as possible. And the one more try codes give me the freedom to do exactly that. So, we are working on the game literally every day, but until today I was able to do the following. refing and redesign the motion model of the game, the movement of the players and the puck physics. Refing and redesign the skating engine. Retune the duration of skating animations, that includes the glide state, regular skate, hustle, backward skating, skating sideways and the crossovers. Completely retune the acceleration animations, these were wrong from the core. Refing and retune the speed of regular skating forward versus skating backwards and skating sideways. Retune the shooting, passing, collisions and hitting animations. Retune the speed of one-touch dekes. Retune the responsiveness and speed of the defensive skill stick. Retune the transitions between animations. Retune all the goalie animations. Retune all the off-play, real-time presentation animations. That includes the face-offs animations, fighting animations, the goal celebration animations, etc. Everything now runs in a correct, realistic speed, as you would expect from a sim in 2018. And last, but definitely not least, we were able to hunt and fix one of the most annoying defensive AI bugs that led to a crazy amount of breakaway situations and left this game basically unplayable from a sim perspective. But we will get into more details about that in the next dire video. Well, I think that's enough for this introduction video. In the next video, we will jump into more details with the gameplay improvements and show you some before-after examples of what was already done. After that, in a third presentation diary video, we will be showing you all the presentation stuff we have done. For example, new real-time cutscenes, new face-offs, camera system, dynamic reflections, HDR tone mapping and most importantly our new broadcast camera 2.0, the most advanced camera system ever seen in a sport video game. And I mean any sport, not just hockey, from any company. Until then, take care guys, see ya.